Good morning. Hello, I'm Jean, and it is Friday, and this is our Stitch Tips and Chat with Captain Stitches. Good morning and welcome, everyone. Thank you for joining me. Let's see who we have here for the early birds. We have Denise, and she says, hello, everyone, from snowy, icy Northeast Illinois. Ooh, well, if it's snowy and icy there, it's already raining here, so that's probably headed our way. And good morning, Debbie is here. Good morning, Mona. Hello, Danielle. Great to see you. Thank you, everyone, for joining me and popping on this morning. It is really rainy here and windy and going to get worse, so we'll just keep our fingers crossed that the internet stays working. Good morning, Blondie. It is so great to see you. And it says the chat disconnected there for a minute, but it's back. That's awesome. Okay. And this morning I have just a little bit of a mismatch of things to share with you because I did not accomplish everything that I would have liked to this week. Productivity was down a little bit, but that's okay. Good morning, Polly. Welcome to you. Part of that, of course, was stitches, you know, getting used to the stitching cottage, which took up a little bit of my time. Good morning, Gladys. It's great to see you also this morning, which, speaking of stitches, she is here in the cottage. However, she already tuckered herself out helping in the stitching cottage this morning. So she is right behind me in her bed, fast asleep. And hopefully she'll stay that way. We'll know if she wakes up. But so, first thing on the agenda for this morning. Good morning, Susan. It is great to see you. It is just a progress report on the Round Robin Quilting Challenge, which this, of course, is round one complete, and we are on round two that you voted for last week, which you voted for. Good morning, Lorraine. You voted for churn dash blocks for the next round, which is round number two. And I do have strips for that already cut, not subcut. And I do have, of course, that round designed for it, which you would think that they would all be the same size. However, no, nothing can be simple on this round robin. Everything has to be a little tricky. Good morning, Melody. It is great to see you also. So there are actually three different sizes of churn dash blocks in this, and a lot of it using 1 1/8 inch strips. But, and just for a little bit of added information, when you are looking for a churn dash block or designing a churn dash block or whatever, there are several names for this block, which you will find that is also called a double monkey wrench, a hole in the barn door. Shoe fly is not the same. That is a little bit different. But you will find different names for the churn dash block. But so I do have it designed. I do have the strips ready to subcut and get started on that. So hopefully I will be either finished or close to being finished with that round next week on Friday when we go live. And there's Mona's pink flower is really showing up in the chat. That's quite pretty, actually. But okay, so the next thing that I have to share with you, and I need to slow down my talking, or this will be a really quick live, which that's okay too. But last week, that's your grandmother's rose. Okay, that is awesome, Mona. I have yellow roses. They're my favorite. I love roses, but yellow is my favorite. My favorite rose. I was playing with yo-yos last week on our Stitch Tips and Chat on Friday, and I was making the pin cushion, which we'll get the pattern out once again to remind you of that and show you. It was this pattern, and it is this one right here that I had started on and was making. And I was able to finish that, and that is what the top looks. We have the side view there with the little yo-yos going all the way around, and they are sewn on, of course, the jumbo yo-yo that we made. And then there is the extra large yo-yo on the bottom that covers the opening of that, which it showed to have this yo-yo sewn on the other way, but it made it when you laid it down, it didn't want to lay down quite right because it made it stick up. So I removed it and decided to sew mine on the other direction so it would sit better. But it is a cute, isn't that a cute, darling pincushion to decorate your sewing area? I love it. I love pincushions. That is completed, and I will be making more of the ones that are on that pattern. And I also am always going through, a lot of times, looking for something else. You know how that is when we go looking for a project that we have in our Stitching Cottage sewing room, whatever it may be that you have. And we come across a different project that we forgot we had. And I know that there are some kind of cross stitchers that watch and join in. So I am reviving this project that I started quite a while ago. It's a combination of embroidery, slow stitching, needlebook, and counted cross stitch, which this was a little counted cross stitch that I did. And I looked for that. If I find it, I will put it in the description box. I'm fairly sure it was a free pattern, but I can't find it again now. But if I find it, I will put it in the files. But you can use whatever little counted cross stitch pattern that you have left over and incorporate it into a needle book or something small, just a frame or whatever, like doing here. This is not finished. These are all pinned on here, waiting to be stitched down and embellished. And this is the back side of it. And it's in two parts because, of course, the stitching needs to be done, so it's not put together yet. There's batting on those. Thank you, Debbie. She says, remember to give the thumbs up. But this is the inside then of it, which this is off an antique heirloom hanky. This actually opens up, which it does have a pocket in the front that I stitch into it. And this is also from a hanky. I have a lot of old handkerchiefs, vintage ones and other that I use. But this is to place your needles in. You end up with two little pockets in the side here also, but you have a place for your pins, and then you have other pages to include your needles on there, which can't get it apart. And then, of course, two little pockets on the back side of there also. And then this, oopsie. Well, I'm missing the snap there. Okay. This piece of decorative lace down here, and that is this on the top, is the selvage from a fabric, and it is embellished with some beadwork. But these are all little individual pockets here, and what they are intended for is to actually hold your thread, your floss, whatever to keep in there for while you're working on the project. And then on this side, this actually has batting behind it, so you will be able to use that also to put your needles in as you are working on your project. This is just going to be a decorative piece up here. And then this is a piece of leftover patchwork, and that is also, if I can get my fingers in here, two bigger pockets that you can store scissors and your pencils, whatever you mark with, that type of thing, a little ruler, and then, of course, we have a little needle minder on there. But hello, Christine Wolf. Welcome. Welcome. Kind of like a junk journal. Yes, only in cloth. And, of course, I just put that. Oops, that's the right direction. But just wanted to give a little reminder of there are lots of ways to use up whatever you have left over, which right up here is a little crocheted flower and a decorative button on that, but and a little rose pinned on the back of there, which happens to be, no, that's actually a bow. It's not a rose. I thought it was a rose. But this is just an idea here. This is how I keep all my supplies and things that I just throw in that I think I may use while I am working on a project like that. These come in really handy. You've seen me show those before. I use those for lots of projects to keep everything in nice and handy. So there you have a tip also. That way we'll set that off to the side. So that are just some of the things to update you on the round robin and show that I did get the pin cushion finished. And of course, you notice it does match the cottage out here. So, but what am I going to work on while we chat now for a while and just catch up? Some of you that are in my Facebook group will notice there was a comment about crocheting and looking, one of the members said she was looking for a scarf pattern to crochet. So I thought, well, I happen to have a scarf, or you can make it larger and make it into a wrap, crochet pattern that I designed several years ago. And I can tell it was several years ago because as I was reading through it again, I noticed, boy, I sure do better on my instructions now than I did way back then. But I did drop that PDF for anyone that wanted to try making that scarf. It's not a real good picture on here, but it is called the Love and Kindness Scarf or Wrap. And that's just the color that the photo is on there. You can make it out of any yarn that you want, which it is actually. And the reason that I made this pattern is because we all, if we crochet, we end up with a lot of leftover odds and ends of yarn left from other projects that we were doing. And it's always a question of what do you do with that yarn? Well, there's many things you can do with it, but I decided to come up with a pattern using, you know, staying within a theme of, you know, one color family or whatever, but it didn't matter what weight, what ply, or what the yarn was. You just gathered up a bunch of your leftover yarns or a couple, you know, new skeins also to throw in there, whatever. And you can use them all in one project, and it comes out beautifully textured and everything. And you can use this as an infinity scarf. It is very long. Or you can, like I said, make it wider, and it can be a wrap to go around your shoulders instead. And if you don't like it always as an infinity scarf, you can't really see too well, but I'll hold it up there and see if it'll won't get on there. But there are buttons that I added on the one end of there. So you could actually button it together to make it as an infinity scarf, or unbutton it and use it as a regular scarf if that is what you wanted to do. But I went ahead and decided I am going to make this up again because I do not have one out of this pattern anymore, because back then I was selling my items, and the wrap that I had and the scarf that I had made out of this were sold long time ago. And I'm trying to get my yarn over on the right side of this. But you actually start by foundation single crocheting, and you will see it is quite long. There it is, doubled. But 230 foundation single crochets. And then the next row is just a single crochet right across. And the rows are different. It's not the same stitch in every pattern. It's kind of like a sampler scarf because the stitches change with the rows and the yarn or the colors change with the rows. Not every row, but in the pattern, it tells you when to change and that type of thing. So I am just going to stitch on this a while. And it is just a, whoops, as we lose our yarn real quick there. Get that back on. But this is just a simple single crochet row that I am working on right now. And I pulled a bunch of my turquoise and teal yarns, which I will show you those in just a minute. And then I pulled an off-white sparkly metallic yarn to throw in with that to give it some interest, which one of the turquoise ones just happens to be a sparkly yarn as well. But so I just went through and pulled out. See, this one has the metallic sparkle in there. But and they're all different as well. This one, which they are all different shades. They're not the same shade. And then we have this one that we threw in with it. This is the beige with the gold sparkle. It's not picking up the sparkle on that one, but it has the sparkle in there as well. This is a sheepish, which a different texture in it. These are all different. And then this is going to be interesting because remember the sachet yarn that we used to make those ruffle scarves out of? Well, you can crochet with that just as a strand also. And I am going to add that in there. So this actually has some sequins and stuff, and it runs, you know, different colors. It's variegated. So that will end up being very, very, add some interest and texture to it. But I just am throwing these back into my little tote here to keep those. And there will be no rhyme or reason to whichever yarn I decide to choose next, except for that ribbon yarn, because there is a stitch. Good morning, Danielle. I may have said good morning to you later, but I just saw your thing. Love that blue yarn color. So vibrant. Yes, it's actually turquoise and teals. It may come across blue, but well, it's a blue green. So technically you can call it blue, but yes, I'm hoping this will be quite an interesting, and depending on, I think I will definitely have enough yarn, and if I don't, I have more I can pull from the stash and add to it. But I think I am going to make it the wrap size, because we have some mighty, and I left these in. I notice I'm coming to one of them. You'll notice there's some stitch markers. There should be, yep, there's another one there. This one actually is now marking the right side. I always mark the right side of my work, but I'm coming up to, I noticed another one, and I just left those in because when I am doing my foundation row, when there is, you know, over 100 stitches in it, you often, as we know, get interrupted while we're counting, and it's very easy to lose track of your counting. So I put those in at every 50 stitches. So if I do lose count, I only have to go back that number to recount and find out how many that I have, which I will take those out now, but I wanted to leave them in so I could also share that tip with you. And I noticed that June bug just popped on. She says, good morning, Jean and everyone. Just sitting at the bus stop, waiting for the boy I am watching today. School got out early because of the storm heading this way. Yes, it looks like most of the, a good portion of the United States is going to have some type of bad weather over the next several days. I know we are supposed to have up to 50 mile an hour winds here. They're already warning about possible power outages. So everybody be prepared, ready, and safe. Have all those batteries charged. Have your, if you have a generator, have it ready. We do not have one. I keep telling my husband we should get one, but we will make do. Which my husband is on oxygen. That's why I keep telling him we should have a generator. But if push comes to shove, we can always get in the car and he can plug in his portable oxygen in there. So need to take a sip of tea. And my tea this morning is Twinings Herbal Tea Winter Spice. And it is one of my favorites. It is, it says, create a relaxing moment with a sweet apple flavor and savory cinnamon, cardamom, and clove spices. But it's really good. Love it in the morning. Oh, yeah, we have no problem with supplies to stay warm. But, and we can't use candles in our house because we have oxygen going 24/7 in our house. So no candles, but we do have other, you know, flashlights and that type of thing. Good morning, Mary. It is great to see you this morning. Lorraine says that she has knit with the sachet yarn. Thank you for the idea to crochet with it. Yes. And like I said, you don't have to use it the way that they used to, you know, make the ruffly scarves. With it, you can just hold it together like it is any strand of yarn. Of course, it would be considered a bulky weight, but in this scarf wrap, I am using all different weights, all different types of yarn, leftover skeins, full skeins, whatever I had that was in the color family that I wanted to work with. And I, of course, am using one of my favorite Furls crochet hooks. It is a size K for this one. It's a beautiful, beautiful swirled blue, but love it. But I love these hooks. It is just like crocheting in air. You don't even feel it. It slides through your yarn just like butter. Love them. What is everyone else working on? Do they have projects set aside for the bad weather coming? Hello, Brenda. Thank goodness it's Friday. Yes, for those of you working, thank goodness it is Friday. Doesn't make any difference here in the Stitching Cottage because this is where I work. And the majority of the time, I don't even know what day it is. And Christine says she made an afghan with her scraps more than 30 plus years ago. It came back to me and I am overjoyed. I'll post a pic in the Facebook today. Awesome. Yeah, it's amazing how some of those things come back, which I say this pattern I also did several years back, but, and it is one that I normally sell the pattern. It may still be on Ravelry even. I'm not sure whether I put this one on there or not, I don't think it is, but I did sell it when I used to go other places. And I did, like I said, for those of you that are in my Facebook group, which is Kept in Stitches and Friends, and the link for that will be in the description box of this video. If you haven't joined and would like to request to join that, you will find the link there. That is where all great things and follow-ups and everything that goes on my YouTube is also there, with some extra added things always going on. Susan says, I am going to try to finish the quilt I was working on last night. It is coming out really nice, and I have to go back and watch the replay on that. Susan, I didn't get the opportunity to watch you last night, so I am going to watch the replay today. And Lori says, I'm working on my tea. Rough night, no sleep. I will watch videos all day. Well, hopefully you don't sleep through them, Lori, or you'll have to watch them again. But I'm sorry that you had a rough night and didn't get much sleep. And Susan says, that is the Afghan I made for my husband years ago. It is made out of all my scrap. Okay, I remember seeing you. I remember you mentioning that one before and showing us, I believe, Susan. Yeah, there were a couple lives I missed last night. Partly because Stitches wouldn't let me use my hands. Sometimes she, at this stage, requires additional attention, but she is doing awesome and is so smart and acclimating to everything very, very quickly. She is doing great, as I was just saying, Danielle. She is adjusting very, very quickly. She is so smart. You tell her something once and she remembers it. Yeah, she is doing great. She, you know, of course, is in the teething stage, so part of that is a little hard. But I do have a pattern that I made her little jacket for, and I think it's a regular, you know, Simplicity Buttrick, one of those patterns that I've had for years, because I've always had dogs. So, but yes, it was made from a pattern that has several different variations. Let's put the yarn there with it. Yes, except, you know, it's amazing how if we are busy and can't stop what we're doing, for being as young as she is, she will play by herself. She pulls out her toys and she just has a great time. As long as she can see us and be in the same room, she will play with her toys and just, you know, be kind of close to your feet or whatever, and entertain herself when we're busy. So that is awesome. And she also, yesterday, I was out here and I thought, it's quiet. Where did she go? And I looked, and the door is open right now. I have the little cage set up here just temporarily. But, and I need to change color on this row. That's what I was looking for. So I'm going to set that down. But I leave the door open on it, and she had gone in and laid down on her bed all by herself and was just laying there asleep. So that was awesome. Right. Yes, right now. Yeah, Loki says that, Danielle says that Loki doesn't require much, just loves laying right beside me no matter where I'm at. That is how Stitches is. She needs to be either by my husband Bob or by me, and she is just fine. And in the evening, she loves to be in either his lap or my lap, and she just zonks out and goes to sleep. Does a little bit of you know, like having a dream whining or whatever in her sleep. It's cute. But Brenda says that she thinks hubby and she will get the daughter's quilt finished this weekend. Took her to a shop hop from the thousands of quilts she picked. Old time pumpkins from old time fabric shop, Indiana. Awesome. Awesome. I would love to see that, Brenda. But that is awesome. So I am ready to change colors. And let me see. Which one of the other tips is I do have a stitch counter that I keep to keep track of the rows that I'm on. Normally I have it on something around my neck, but I can't find that one right now. So this is just an extra one in my hand. Okay, Lori says she will be right back. But I need to click that to make sure that I don't forget what row I'm on here. But I'm going to be changing color, and I am going to be doing double crochet across to set up for the next row's stitch. I can tell that because it is a setup for being able to do the row after that. So I am going to add my, and you can't see there, but I am going to cut my yarn, and I am going to do, it's always the opposite direction. I don't leave too much because I want the yarn to change, but I do a joining. I think we will go ahead and add the sparkle. The sparkle on next for the rows that are coming up. And I'm going to try. It's not going to show up, of course, on the color that we have here. We'll put white under that. I'm trying to get where I can still see it and show you a little also. But I have the end of the yarn that I just cut. And I'm laying that out. And I'm laying the other one right across from that. And I'm going to take, and on the top side, I am going to just tie this new one on. I leave enough room for my finger to get it through there. But I'm tying that on. And then I am taking the other end and tying it on, but on the bottom side with my knot instead. And you have something, and I will pick this up. It will look like this when you have those tied. And you make sure that you have it tied nice and tight. And then you just slide those two ends together like that. It will not come undone, will not come apart. Okay. Couldn't figure out why my watch was. If you pull this way right now, it will. But after you have it in there, that will not come apart. And you can cut these ends very, very, very close. And I just pulled my stitches out there, but that's all right. So that you will not notice that in there when you go, and you don't have any ends to bury on your adding another yarn that way, which I pulled out my stitch there. So I'm just putting that back in and turn that back over so I can read. But what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be doing a double crochet now. So I'm going to turn, chain two, and do a double crochet in each stitch across. And I don't like to do it that way anymore. I am actually only going to chain one so that I can double crochet in that very very first stitch. I like the way that the edge stays straighter doing it that way. Hello, Patty G. Welcome, welcome. Christine says she will go back on replay and watch. I have the hardest time keeping color changes from coming untied. And I will put a link to a YouTube video or whatever that shows that knot better also in the Facebook group, Christine, so that you can find that and watch it, because I don't remember what the actual join is called. But I love it, and I use that on everything that I can. So now this row is just going to be double crochet all the way across. And at some point in time in one of my Wednesday tip demo ones, when I have a camera angle set up better, I will go through and show some of the things that I do close up also for better. But during the live, I don't have that set up to be able to do that yet. Sorry, I apologize. But this will be fun to work on. Stuff like this I normally work on when I am inside having to check and spend time with my husband. Because I call this also mindless stitching for me. But yeah. But I know that I miss that. Patty said that great cape fabric has been delivered in my mailbox. Ooh, who would bundle up and walk to get it? You, of course, I would too, Patty. Which I actually have to, you know, walk in the weather back and forth from the house to the cottage all the time. So... And because of the nerve damage in my foot, I am not able to wear shoes. So sometimes I get a wet foot when it starts raining. But I keep a heavier sweater out here that I can throw on when it's really cold. Otherwise, I just walk quickly. As quickly as I can for those of you that aren't aware, I have no feeling in my right foot, and I have nerve damage that has pain. I have both knees replaced and both hips replaced, and I have a bad back and other things. So I do not walk fast. I walk as quickly as I can, and very carefully. Patty G says, I'm anxious to not go get it. It's 5 yards. Oh, right. Okay, I got you. It's 5 yards of cape. Ooh, yep. Oh, that sounds awesome. That sounds awesome. And Danielle says, I wish I had a cottage so I could have my own dedicated space. Currently, I have to share my space with the birds and storage. LOL. Fingers crossed the storage will be gone by sometime spring. Well, that would be nice. That would at least help, Danielle. And she says that she has nerve damage and spasms in my left foot. So we would make a great team. we would make one of those pillow races. Left leg. Okay. Yeah, mine is kind of from just above the knee down, but can't feel my foot at all. So yes, it's very, very interesting learning to adapt and walk. But and of course you know the pain that that comes from that from time to time also. So I understand your lack of sleep also, Lori, because it seems to really like to act up at night. But like I said, this is the kind of stuff I work on to have on hand, because I have to be working on something all the time. I can't just sit in a chair and do nothing. So I always have something to be working on by hand sitting next to my chair. And this will work up very, very quickly. And Danielle says that she thinks the worst part is getting woken from a beautiful slumber with searing spasms. Yes, yes, yes. And I also, because I am severely anemic, severely vitamin D deficient and low calcium, I have bone breaking pain that will also wake you up from a dead sleep at night. And it is like, yeah, not fun, but we don't need to go on to all that. I am someone, I don't let those things get to me. Don't let me, it does bother me, but I don't let it bother me. I adapt. It's part of life. I'm not going to start living my life. So I just adapt and go on. Which part of the problem is the last I'll say about it is I am a disabled veteran. So some of them come from things that happened in my time in service. That's right, Danielle says. As long as we can still do what we love, then that's what matters. Yes. And that's like, yes, crocheting does hurt my hands, but my hands hurt whether I'm crocheting or doing hand stitching or anything anyway. And I feel that to continue doing it helps keep the movement and helps keep them limber and able to have use of them longer than if I wasn't continuing to work through the pain. Plus, I totally love all things hand stitching and am not willing to give it up. What's that saying? Where there's a will, there's a way. But that's coming out quite, yeah, I think when I move it, you can see the sparkle in the yarn there, but which we probably won't get to it, but the next row is going to be, which is one of my favorite stitches, is going to be a front post double crochet and then a back post double crochet, which makes a really cute ribbing. Lots of nice, pretty texture in that. And that's why I decided when I saw that was coming up and it was still going to be, oh, it says with new color though. Oh, well, we can see. We don't always have to change the color when it says the color or the yarn. That's totally up to you. But I thought that would be pretty in the sparkly one. Good morning, June. Welcome. Great to see you. All of you Junes are hard to keep track of, and the Marys. I think there's like 3 or 4 Junes and there's 3 or 4 Marys always in the comments, and it's like, okay, keep track of which one I'm chatting with, or is the comment commenting on it on a video or a live afterwards. But and I love all your comments to all my videos. You guys are so great and awesome that follow me. I appreciate and enjoy each and every one of you. That's why my Facebook group is called Captain Stitches and Friends, because I consider you all my friends. Which, you know, the group is new again, just getting off the ground, so things are a little bit slow right now at this stage, but things will get more active in there, which did have the first Zoom stitch day yesterday. We'll have to say it was a little quiet, so hopefully some of you decide to check that out and find out just how fun and exciting a virtual stitch day with others can be. Most of the time, it will just be working on whatever you want to work on and chatting along with others, getting to know each other, picking up ideas from everyone else. And then at times there will be a special project that is optional for those that want to join in, and we will work on together. June says she is snowing in the wind is blowing. Yes, I am. Yes, I am. She must have answered somebody else's. Oh, Brenda asked her if she was snowed in. June, do you live in Ohio? Why did I think you live in Ohio, but farther north of me? Because right now it's still Iowa. That's right. Right above, up and above us. Okay. I knew it was close, but yeah, Iowa's has gotten quite a bit of snow. And Denise, I believe it was, it's in Illinois, said it was snowing and icy there. So I say, I think quite a few of us are in for some type of the storm today and the days to come, which I think ours, they're talking about the thunderstorms today. Odd time of year for the thunderstorms. So not always good when that happens either. But we all have our stitching to keep us busy and keep our minds off the weather, and we can be in our warm, cozy, comfortable, creative areas and work on our stitching to our heart's content. June says, we had that when I lived in South Dakota. Yes. And Danielle says, they are calling for approximately 6 inches of snow tomorrow for Michigan in my area. And you are right above me, Danielle. I don't know what part of Michigan you live in, but I grew up in Minnesota, so I definitely know what cold and snow is like. And it can be mighty cold here in Ohio also. We used to get more snow in Ohio, but the last several years, we haven't gotten the amount that we used to. I don't mind, since I am the only person that can drive in our family now, and I really don't care to drive in snow. I especially don't care to drive in icy conditions, and I don't drive at night in the rain, cannot see. Okay, 2 miles north of Detroit. So that's kind of centrally located, isn't it? If I recall, Danielle. Not upper and not lower. I was in Detroit one time at the airport changing planes around the bottom of the thumb. Okay. On the east side. I'd say we're almost across that row. Check that time out. Yeah, back to talking about the churn dashes on the next round of the Round Robin Challenge. The four corners are, you know, the perfectly square 4x4 churn dash blocks. The ones across the top and the bottom are wider so that they end up fitting within the space. And the ones that go on both sides are elongated. So there are three different sizes so that they all fit going around the entire border on the next round. Lots of pieces to cut. I forget how many there are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 16 churn dash blocks in that next round. Not too bad, but they're tiny pieces. How far am I from the Ohio-Michigan border? Quite a ways, because I'm in kind of the south central part of Ohio. So it's yeah, probably, I don't know, six hour drive at least, if not more. I'm south of Columbus, if that helps, Danielle. Speaking of Columbus, our treasured home, Nancy, hasn't joined us today. And Mona was on earlier. She is an Ohio gal also. She's closer to the Michigan Ohio border. But there was just something that came up, and it's funny how you associate things, because I know the, and I'm not going to say the exact city, but it came up and I went, well, that's where Mona lives. It's funny how we associate areas and things like that. And Danielle says, it does. I go by that way when I go visit with my brothers in Tennessee. Oh, awesome. Well, you might have to stop in the stitching cottage on one of those trips down or back, Danielle. That would be awesome. That would be totally awesome. There are so many of us in the area. I think it would be awesome to be able to have a 3-day retreat centrally located for a bunch of us to have the opportunity to attend and enjoy. And I'm always trying to plan something like that in my mind. One day it may come to fruition. We will see. Danielle says that would be so cool. Thanks for the invite. Probably won't be until either late fall or next year. Have to get my truck frame fixed. I understand that. My traveling days are over. I'm too old to be traveling alone anymore for any long distance. So if family can't come and see me, I can no longer get to them because they are miles and miles and miles and miles away. My son and two grandchildren and daughter-in-law, of course, live in Wyoming. And my other son lives in Oklahoma. And both my sisters live in Minnesota, and I have a brother in Colorado and a brother in Florida. No one close. Good morning, Teresa. It is great to see you. I haven't caught your last couple lives either. Sometimes I have problems with those evening ones. I seem to be busier at that time, but I usually am able to go back and catch the replays. Thank goodness we have replays for the lives. But I was just thinking of both you, Shady Susan, and Teresa Louise the other night. You both popped into my head. Isn't it nice to know you're thought of? So I am almost at to the end of this row, and it says to change yarn again, but I'm debating on whether I really want to, because I think but then if I go to the one that is the lighter color, that would really stand out also. So I will go ahead and change. Hope it was good thoughts. Hope it was good thoughts. Yeah, you both said that. Yes, it was definitely good thoughts. Now, why would there be anything for it to be bad thoughts? No, definitely good thoughts. Oh, I do not ever have bad thoughts. No, not about any of my stitching friends. Oh, that is funny, and that you both typed it at the same time. But no. Definitely no bad thoughts. And I am going to make this one just a little longer because that is double crochet that I'm adding on to there. And let me see. I'm going to go ahead and use the only one that is a totally different color, so that will show up quite. I was making sure there wasn't a ball that was going to be stuck in the start of that. I wish I could hold this up so you could see how I am actually tying this. this knot. But like I said, I will do that in one of my Wednesday recorded videos so I can show how I actually do that knot and join my yarn so I don't have all the ends to have to bury in afterwards. It's really very easy once you get used to it. And I have never had any of them come apart, but it looks like that. And then you just slide it together. It's tight, will not come apart. And you can cut those ends off right up next to the knot so there isn't anything sticking out. And you will not find that in your stitching after your project is done. But I forget what the knot is called. I will look it up and I will leave it in the description box. And remember to mark your row on your stitch counter so you don't forget where you are. So I am going to be doing front post double crochet and back post double crochet all the way across this row. So again, though, I do not chain two for mine. I leave it as a standing so that the row is nice and straight and flat on mine instead of having that pokey out there from chaining two. So we are going to start with a front post double crochet, which goes around the one of the previous row. That first one's a little tricky to do. And then we are going to do a back post on the next one. And going to alternate between those two all the way across. And that is going to give it a ribbed texture effect. Christine says, it's so bad that I crocheted Rose Afghan for granddaughter when she was born. Daughter-in-law washed it per instructions and all the roses came undone. Oh no, I am so sorry, Christine. That had to be an awful, awful feeling. All that work. If I can't use that knot someplace, I actually do what they call sewing in the ends so that I know that they're not going to come undone. What did I miss that June said? That you are looking forward to the video. Magic knot. That's it. Thank you. Thank you, Susan. That is exactly what it is called, the magic knot. Oops. And I do use it all the time. But I'm going to see. You see how that makes the texture in there? So we're going to have texture running throughout this pattern and some rows that don't have the texture. All different stitches that are going to be used in this. Danielle says, how do you decide who to put as your moderators? Well, our moderator that we have today, Teresa Louise, is one that volunteered when I first started out and I didn't have any moderators at all. And I said something about not having one. And Teresa said that she would moderate for me. So she has had that wrench and she can choose to use it or not ever since I have had my channel. Couple others volunteered and then a couple that I also asked. But yeah, just just ask and you will usually get somebody that is on quite often and they will volunteer for you, Danielle, which if you need a moderator, I would gladly moderate for you. Awesome. Thank you, though, Susan. Yeah, it was like, yeah, I use it all the time, but I can never remember what it's called. But and when it comes to moderators, they're never all going to be able to be there at the same time. So it's good to have more than one. A lot of times, like this live that I do now, there isn't a lot that needs to be done. So I'm not nervous or like, oh no, I don't have a moderator. But there are times that they do definitely help. And I also have it set to where there is a delay. You have to be a subscriber on my lives, which I noticed that you do have that also, Danielle. So you know what I'm talking about there. But we are a little past 12 and I have gone over everything. I am on row 4 already of this scarf and there are 23 rows total in the scarf. If you do it as the wrap, there are actually 46 because you repeat all 23 stitches again. And I am hoping to do this one as the wrap. But thank you, Danielle. I was debating on whether to do it in the turquoise yarns or I have a bunch of red, which I may do it in both. Who knows what I will do? Always ideas popping into my head. But we went over the progress on the round robin. I need to put your granny. Teresa needs to put her granny squares together. Yes, I love granny squares, but hate having to put them together. Could do red, white, and blue. I could, but I don't wear so much red, white, and blue in the wintertime. I do have a beautiful red one. I haven't ever done red, white, and blue in the winter. I don't know why. Just haven't. But that is something I'd have to think about. But I did complete the pin cushion that I was working on last time, having fun with yo-yos. And it came out beautifully. I like it. Sits there real, real nice. And then I did show what you can do with your scraps and everything. And of course, still working on this one. And especially wanted to show for the people that do the counted cross stitch that watch, that when you have just something little that you've done, you know, some different ways to incorporate that and use it into your other forms of stitching. We'll have to see the colors in your granny squares. Oh, Patty G says that she really likes the colors you used in your granny squares. So yes, I will definitely have to go and check those out. But so thank you all for joining me again this morning. You may have noticed that this week I did, and it was just short and sweet this time, but am starting my tip demo, and it's on Wednesdays instead of Tuesdays now. That is a recorded one, not live, but doing that. And I probably will be doing, bye-bye, Danielle. Thank you. See you. And I will probably be doing my week in review as a separate video. Again, also, it seems to work better that way. So watch for those. And I will see you all again very soon. Thank you. Thank you, Teresa, for being here. And everyone that has joined in on the chat this morning. Take care. Stay warm. Stay safe. Don't blow away. Don't slide away. Stay home if you can. And remember, in the meantime, I can keep you in stitches. Bye-bye, everyone.